Hello students, in the previous session we learnt about acids, bases and salts and where they are found. Today we will learn about indicators. So let's start.
So students, as we discussed in the previous session, we can taste something and determine whether it is an acid or a base. If the taste is sour, for example, a lemon, it will contain an acid. And if the taste is bitter, for example, baking soda, then it will be a base. But it is not safe to taste every substance to find out if it is acidic or basic. There are some special substances that have different colors in acidic and basic mediums. These substances are known as indicators. The indicators change their color when added to the solution containing an acidic or a basic substance. So indicators are those substances which determines whether a given substance is acidic or basic by changing their color. So you should not taste anything because it can be poisonous or toxic. In this case, indicators are a lifesaver. Now, many indicators are naturally available to us. So some naturally occurring indicators are litmus, turmeric, China rose petals, which is also called gudhal, and red cabbage juice. These indicators show different colors in acidic and basic media. They are used to test whether a substance is acidic or basic in nature. Now let us understand what is litmus and how is it obtained. So, a naturally occurring indicator, litmus, is obtained from certain lichens. Lichens are nothing but small plants and used as a dilute solution. So litmus has a purple color in water. In an acidic solution, it turns red. When it is added to a basic solution, it turns blue. Usually, it is available as a red and blue litmus paper. You can get those easily from your nearby stationery shop. So, how do they make litmus papers? They take the lichens. After that, they make a solution from it. And with the help of the solution, they dye the paper. I hope you know what is the meaning of dye. It's not D-I-E. It's D-Y-E. Dye means to color. So when we take the litmus paper and dip it in an acidic solution, its color will turn red. And if we take the litmus paper and dip it in a basic solution, its color will turn blue. Another natural indicator is easily available at your home. It is turmeric. Turmeric is a bright yellow powder obtained from a plant. It is called haldi in Hindi. Turmeric contains a yellow dye and turmeric turns red in basic solution. It is used as indicator in the form of a turmeric paper. So as the litmus paper is made from litmus dye, turmeric paper can also be made from turmeric dye. So turmeric paper which is available in the market, it is yellow in color. You can make it at home as well. What you can do is, you can make some turmeric powder solution with water and after that you can dip the paper inside it. After that, when you dry the paper, the dye of turmeric will get stuck on the paper. And this is how you will make a turmeric paper. Now, in the first session, I told you that baking soda is basic in nature. So you can try it yourself. What you can do is, You can make a solution of baking soda and put it on the turmeric paper. So what you will see is the color of turmeric paper will turn to red. Now the next indicator is China rose. It is also very easily available because many people offer it to God. So China rose as an indicator is a natural indicator. It is called Gudhal in Hindi, and it is extracted from the red flowers of China rose plant with water. Now, I have not mentioned the color change of China rose. You have to do it yourself and write it in your notebook. You will find it when you read the book. Now, students, if you want to measure the distance, you can say that it is exactly 500 meters. Or if you want to measure the temperature, then you can say that it is 42 degrees Celsius. So you can say it specifically. Similarly, if you want to say whether the substance is acidic or not, you have indicators for it. But if I ask you how acidic or how basic a substance is, then there is a way to measure it. So it is pH scale. So pH is a measure of how acidic or basic anything is. The range of pH goes from 0 to 14, with 7 being neutral. pH of less than 7 indicate acidity, whereas pH of greater than 7 indicates base. You can compare it with a number line as well. For example, above 0, a number line has positive integers, and below 0, a number line has negative integers. Similarly, in this pH scale, above 7 it is acidic. Above 7 it is basic, and below 7 it is acidic. But the range is only from 0 to 14, so it cannot go beyond these points. In this image, I have shown you different substances and their pH value. Here you will see that pure water has a pH of 7, so it is neutral. What is the meaning of neutral? It is neither acidic nor basic. And you know that pure water is tasteless. So it is neither acidic nor basic. Now, students, due to rapid industrialization and pollution, a very devastating thing happens, which is called acid rain. Now, what is the meaning of it? The rain containing excess of acids is called an acid rain. What is the meaning of that? That when the rain comes with water, acid also falls from the sky. Why does this happen? The rain becomes acidic because carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen dioxide dissolve in raindrops to form carbonic acid, sulfuric acid, and nitric acid respectively. It can cause damage to buildings, historical monuments, plants, and animals. One very famous example is there. It is Taj Mahal. Do you know that Taj Mahal's color is slowly changing from white to yellow because of the industrial pollutants as well as acid rain? It is very sad for us, and we have to decrease the pollution. In this image, you can see how an acid rain forms. First, when the water evaporates, the pollutants like sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide mixes with the water and form clouds. After that, they form acids like nitric acid and sulfuric acid, and they fall on the ground as acid rain. Here, H2O means water, NO2 means nitrogen dioxide, SO2 means sulfur dioxide, HNO3 means nitric acid, and H2SO4, it is sulfuric acid. All these are chemical formulae. You will study about it in later classes. So students, today we studied about some natural indicators and their properties. After that, we studied about acid rain. There are also some indicators which are not naturally available, but they are prepared in laboratory. We will study about it in the next session. Till then, read the book and I'll see you next time. Take care.